To learn more about the science of corrosion and rust protection, we interviewed one of the world's leading corrosion experts, Dr. Digby Macdonald. Dr. Macdonald is currently a professor with the Departments of Materials Science and Engineering and Nuclear Engineering at the University of California at Berkeley. In his distinguished and award-winning career, Dr. Macdonald has published more than 930 academic papers in scientific journals, books, and conference proceedings. He is the author of 4 books, is the holder of 10 patents, and was a finalist in 2011 for the Nobel Prize for Chemistry. Here are just a few of the many awards Dr. Macdonald has received in the past 30 years from all over the world. In this exclusive interview, Dr. Digby Macdonald explains what causes corrosion and how Final Coat's patented technology protects automobiles against rust.
Well, when we build new materials, a material has a certain fitness for use. That is, it will perform its function within a given environment for as long as required. And the process that opposes that is corrosion, destruction of material by the environment. You have to understand that nature is trying to take the metals that we win from ores back to their natural oxidized state. Okay, and that's called corrosion. So the process of winning the metals from the ore is important, but as far as the functionality of whatever we make is concerned, corrosion is the dominant process, and it's extremely expensive. Partly because of the environment. When we drive cars along the roads in northern part of North America, of course there's salt on the road, which is put there to de-ice the roads. And salt contains chloride ion. And chloride ion is nature's agent for breaking down the phenomenon we call passivity, which protects a metal, and returning the metal to its oxidized state. So it's the chloride ion which is the bad actor. And it's ubiquitous. It's everywhere. In fact, they put it by the truckload on the road. There's a natural tendency for the metals to form a very thin oxide film on a metal surface that effectively separates the reactive metal from the corrosive environment. So long as that thin oxide film exists and remains intact, then the corrosion rate is so low that the metal can be used for its intended purposes. It's when that oxide film breaks down that you get the problem. And I've spent my career developing the modern theory of passivity and passivity breakdown, so it's a subject that I know probably better than anyone else in the world. Final coat works essentially by inducing a current into the body of the automobile. The little box that you put on the automobile body induces a current. That current causes the passive film on the zinc to break down, so the zinc becomes active again and hence protects the steel. That's only done by using a pulse. So it's a AC method. Whereas cathodic protection is a DC method. You apply a constant voltage. But there's another very important difference. With cathodic protection, you need an electrolyte return path. That is, you pump electrons in, say, here, they flow through the body to here, then there has to be a return path where ions flow through an electrolyte. Generally, you don't have that in an automobile, unless it's, you know, submersed in the sea. I was intrigued when Adam Fanacki, who was a lawyer who was working for Randy, asked me if I would appear before the Competition Bureau in Ottawa, because this was fundamentally different than a cathodic protection system. And by the way, it employed a form of corrosion protection that had never been noted before. This was something quite new. Okay, so, you know, Randy can be famous for having introduced an entirely new corrosion control and prevention technique. Oh yes, it works. And you know, we've got all sorts of experimental data that says it works. Final coat is an AC technique. and it induces a current in the body of the vehicle. You can measure that current. We've done that. Okay. And it follows Maxwell's equations, and so we understand. It's like a radio antenna. Same principle. Radio receiver takes an electromagnetic wave and produces a current in the antenna that we then amplify, and we hear music. Okay, it's the same principle. You know, it's part of public acceptance. But public acceptance depends a great deal upon acceptance by the scientific community. And that's what happened with the Competition Bureau in Ottawa. We were able to convince them that this device was for real. Okay? And they reversed their decision because they initially decided against final coat. They lumped it together with Rust Buster, okay? Cathodic protection device. Wouldn't work. I agreed with them. So it wouldn't work. But it's not a cathodic protection device. It turns out, so Adam Fanacki tells me, that this is the only time the Competition Bureau ever reversed themselves. So, you know, that's not some small victory. That was a great victory. Well, you know, I had my doubts too initially when I was approached initially about this. I had been looking at Rust Buster, and I said, oh, it's just another version of Rust Buster. Until I went over the characteristics of the device and said, but this is not a cathodic protection system. It doesn't work that way. So the next question was, how does it work? Okay, and that's where I came to the conclusion, based upon some work done at Ohio State University, that induces a current into the body of the automobile. And eventually I came to the conclusion that the real problem was the passivation of zinc. And so the galvanized steel, the zinc coating was not working as it should on galvanized steel. Okay, and we had to reactivate the zinc. So the device had to activate the zinc and allow the zinc to do its job in protecting the steel. I work very closely with Jason and with Mike and Todd and everybody else. Jason was one of my PhD students at Penn State. And this is a very competent team of people. You know, I challenge you to find another team of people anywhere in the automobile industry who come even close to what they have here. Okay? You know, they've got the whole spectrum of skills necessary, chemistry, electrochemistry, physics, to deal with the problem. They've got a stranglehold on the technology. I mean, it's well protected by patents. That doesn't mean that there are not people trying to copy it. There's always people trying to copy it, and that, of course, is the best form of flattery.